It is breaking my heart.
It's breaking my heart.
That Southwest Florida father says his kids no longer feel safe at school. He says a severe case of bullying against his daughter escalated into a brawl at this Charlotte County bus stop.
Someone on the school bus took this video of the fight at the stop in Harbor Heights, and you can see somebody start to throw punches, repeatedly hitting another student, throwing her to the ground. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis shows us how even parents got into the brawl.
The bus drop-off this afternoon, pretty uneventful. The Charlotte County Sheriff's Office did station an officer here just in case. But the events of the last couple of days, fights right here at the bus stop, has a lot of parents asking questions. Fights on Wednesday, a bleed over from fights on Tuesday.
It isn't just picking on, these aren't just words, now it's physical violence.
Chris Payne's oldest daughter was one of several involved in the Wednesday fight that ended up on video.
I had, like, my whole shirt was ripped yesterday. It was, like, ripped off. I told them to stay away from my sister. Told them that there was any problems if they keep on messing with her.
But parents at the bus stop and later watching the video say it was much more.
They just go at it fighting. And then all of a sudden there's a lot of other ruckus.
The school district is looking into it, reviewing the videos and finding out what happened. Along with law enforcement.
There's a lot of questions that's still being asked about it, and we're investigating it right now.
Asking for students to speak up before situations become this serious.
That every child should be able to come to school without being frightened, without being harassed, without being intimidated.
But for parents and students at the stop, it's too late.
At what point do you just say, fine, I'll do whatever I have to do to protect my kids?
We got to teach our children the right way, and this is not the right way. Fighting is not the way to solve anything.
The Payne family tells me that they're considering all of their options, but they are hopeful that the law enforcement investigation, along with the district, brings some sort of answers. Reporting in Charlotte County, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.
Now to an NBC2.